Hello, Forecaster here again, and we are back for episode 66 of Enter the Gungeon, and I just discovered something new. The first thing is I just unlocked the A key 47 by talking to the elevator guy, which I apparently hadn't done since I unlocked the final elevator. Which I completely forgot what's the thing. So he said he found the AK-47 down while working on the elevator, of course, but dropped it into the shaft, so it's in the gungeon somewhere, of course. And he also said something more. He said that he had skimmed some of the resources that I had collected for him, and he had constructed a special elevator, and I already know what it is, of course, because I had to check, which prompted me to start recording. And this, if we switch to it, it'll say what it is. A boss rush mode, which generally means that you fight a number of bosses straight up with no regular enemies in between or anything like that. So we're going to check that out, and I haven't tried this yet, of course. So we're going to see what happens. Presumably, Keep of the Lead Lord Chamber ? So presumably, we're going to start with the first floor boss, and it is the Gatling Gull. Skip the intro. Unfortunately, we only have the starting weapon, since of course we haven't gone through a floor, collected any chests. Presumably we'll still get a reward for beating the boss, and we might have gotten a master round if I hadn't messed up. Which would have made the following bosses a bit easier. Presumably. Dang it. I don't know if we will get healed between bosses or not, or anything like that. So, it's probably pretty important to preserve as much health as possible, which is not always an easy thing to do. Then again, fighting a bunch of bosses all after one another is probably not supposed to be easy. We don't get any hegemony credits, of course. We get the triple crossbow, though, and the ammo, which we can't actually use. And yeah. And then presumably, oh, leads right into the next boss, which is also a first floor boss, of course. Now I'm going to see about turning on setting my mouse to enter the Gungeon mode, which I haven't done. Alright. So now I can use the mouse to reload again, which is always nice. So we are fighting all the bosses. I thought that it might have us fight just one boss from each floor at random, just all the bosses in a row, but apparently we are fighting each boss, so we'll first fight all three of the first floor bosses, and then we'll presumably fight all of the second floor bosses, and then all of the third floor bosses, and so on. At least this time I managed to not get hit, so we get a master round. We can refill this ammo. Interestingly, it captured the weapon sprite as it was just when I picked that up, apparently. And this is, of course, going to lead right into the Bullet King on his lead throne. We, of course, have the ammo drop as well, because we are the Marine. Don't know if that is going to be of much use. I wonder if we are going to... I wonder if we would have gotten a second first floor master round from beating this boss if I hadn't gotten hit again. Or if we would have gotten nothing for that because we already had the master round. It would have been interesting to see. Maybe we'll get the chance. Ooh, bullet bore is nice. Maybe we'll get the chance on the one of the second floor bosses. Okay, so then we go down. Actually, go down to the next floor. Gungeon proper. And then we'll move right into the bosses for this floor. I'm going to be able to flawless this one. Dang it. Or not. Okay, that was less than brilliant, as was that. This isn't going very well. Still have some chance, though, I think. Should be able to take it out rather quickly with that. And we get the mass shotgun, which is not a bad pickup. And I presume that the weapons are random as usual. Okay, we got a boss door there, which is odd. Didn't get that in the on the previous floor, I'm pretty sure. Boss rooms just led straight into each other. Dang it. So we only get 3 blanks per floor, or 2. Yeah, 2 is the default, of course. And then when we are finished with the bosses of a floor, we get 2 new ones as per the standard rules, of course. Which a lot of sense. There we go, no flawless on this one either. And we get the clear Guanstone, which I forget what it does. Negates poison damage. Well, we are now going to fight the Gorgon. So that is actually pretty handy. We can just stick to this, probably. Yeah. So we can ignore this. Should be able to get a flawless on this one. She is relatively easy. Out of range. There we go. So we currently have one flawless per floor, which is better than none. Dodge up. Improves dodging. Okay. Well, that's good. Suppose. We're doing well on health, at least, to get a lot of health on each floor. I wonder if this room can still have a secret room. I would presume no. Still haven't gotten an active item. I wonder if you fight them in order of difficulty. You might. Don't really think so, though. Dang it. It's going to be difficult to hit properly in this mode. Dang it. Ah, crap. I took my hand off the mouse there to scratch my eye. That was not a brilliant move. I like having two stones orbiting me. Especially a red and a blue one's pretty. It's a pretty nice effect. I think when the large sphere explodes, there's an actual explosion that kind of destroys bullets in the immediate vicinity of it. Okay. No. That should do it. Yep. So no flawless there either. The alien engine is not particularly useful in this situation. Did you use the supply drop? Refill this. We'll continue to the next boss. I suspect I'm not going to be able to complete this. I'm going to die because I'm no longer doing well on health. That was a terrible. Dang it. Very poor timing on that one. But one positive thing, I mean, this is the first time I'm doing this. That is my excuse. Plus, I'm pretty terrible at this game. Although, not as bad as I was when I started, so there's that. But playing this mode is going to give me a lot of practice fighting the bosses, obviously. Because you get to fight them without... Ow. Okay. Without any delay in between, obviously. That's not where the boss was at all. I hate those grenade things. I hate them. We are running out of cover. Should be able to beat this one though, maybe, if I can avoid getting hit while the wars detonate. This should be the final one. There we go. That was really close. Why do I still get keys in this mode? That is weird. I guess that increases the difficulty a bit because they take up potential drop slots for other things. I wish I had gotten more ammo for the triple crossbow because it's actually really, really good when fighting bosses. Oh, we're fighting the Door Lord again, so that answers a question that I had, which was if secret bosses could appear in this mode, which it can. I wonder if the Door Lord is a third floor boss specifically. That may very well be the case. Damn it. Ah. Well, that went pretty well for a first try, I suppose. I can't try again. Oh yeah, it said that the first play was free, so I assume that subsequent ones, like this one, are going to cost hegemony credits. It's probably going to ask. One thing about that special elevator, I keep having to repair it. So I'm going to have to charge you to use it. Just 3 credits per ride. That's perfectly fine. It's another use of all of these credits. And we have learned some things. That's for sure. Should hopefully have fewer distractions this time around, so should have some should have better performance as well. And he used his super shot to destroy that one bush, the one remaining shrubbery. That was close. Now we're going to get rockets Dang it. Always tend to misjudge angle of that. I hate that. Whoops. Did not mean to do that. Also we get a bunch of health that we cannot use. We get boss doors now. Before? I actually don't know. And as usual, the super meat gun turns the room into absolute chaos with all the saw blades that are bouncing around. But they are doing a lot of damage. We'll be able to flawless this one easily. Unless I do that. So, the mystery of what happens if we flawless two bosses on the same floor is going to remain for a while longer. Because even if I flawless this one, of course, I'm not going to find out the answer because it's going to be the first one on this floor. But maybe the next one, maybe. I'm going to continue playing this off-camera for a while. Get some practice in. Because I am still pretty terrible at most of these bosses. You can fire a lot quicker by repeatedly pressing the trigger button instead of holding it down for a lot of weapons. Except the fully automatic ones, like the assault rifle and such. I can't teleport. Oh, I can go back and get health that has dropped previously, of course. Pretty sure if I were to leave ammo behind, the rat would come and pick it up, because I'm technically not in that room anymore. But, of course, health doesn't... he doesn't pick up health. For one thing. Get two new blanks. We're going to face the beholster again. I'll be able to flawless one or two bosses on this floor. Ah, dang it. Keep doing that. I blame the saw blades this time. Oh. And appropriately, we get the Eye of the Beholster gun. Which I suppose I will use, because it is a decent weapon. I mean, it'll spawn companions, which will do additional damage. Lot of them, actually. Nice. Well, that's one flawless on this floor, at least. Have I gotten health from something else? I start with 3 hearts. I have 2 master rounds. This doesn't give health. Oh. Wait, no. Don't know where the extra heart came from. That's odd. But whatever. Let's continue. We aren't immune to poison this time, I have to remember that. I don't like this. It's weird. Dodging that from above. It's kind of a disadvantage. Because my screen, of course, is rectangular. So, the best... no. The best angle, of course, is to the side. Because that's where I can see the furthest. Nope. This is the last boss on the floor, so using up my blanks on this one isn't going to matter too much. There she is. Should be able to kill her before that wave reaches me. Is that... That was our second flawless on this floor, wasn't it? So that means that you don't get anything from flawlessing a boss twice on the same floor. Or flawlessing two bosses on the same floor. Yeah, flawless that one. And then we flawlessed this one and we only got one master round. Which makes sense because they are supposed to be unique. Guess... I'm going to use the supply drop, and I'm going to refill this gun. I think it's a little more useful. And we get an active item this time, the... What's it called? Fortune's Favor. Enemy bullets go wide, which I don't think I have ever actually used. But I suppose we will now try it out. And yeah, might be useful. Ideally, I would like to flawless one of these bosses. I'm going to use it during one of the more annoying stages. Oops, that was close. Rapid fire, whoa. That was close. Cause it's kind of making bullets go around us, which is interesting. I wish it was easier to see when the item expires without having to look in the corner. Because in that case, I had to focus on dodging, but at the same time, I needed to know when the item expired. Oh, the Hack Blaster is nice. It's actually going really well this time. I wanted to keep an eye on myself and the bullets, but I also wanted to see when the effect of this item expired, because that's when I was going to have bullets start hitting me again, or risk hitting me. Now, of course, we don't really need to flawless anything else on this floor. Because I already have the the master round. I don't know why I fired that way. Probably because there were bullets coming from there. Return fire reflex. Let's get rid of that. I think continuously strafing around this thing is the better strategy. Ah well. Like I said, that doesn't really matter. Because we wouldn't have gotten anything from that anyway, or from not getting hit, except we would have had one more piece of armor, of course. But we got that back anyway. Although, if I hadn't gotten hit, we would have had 4 pieces of armor now, so... yeah. Could have used that, of course. Probably should have done that. Let's try this again. And it is the Doorlord again, so I guess that is consistent. I think those bullets to the sides there are different. Might indicate that you're going to fight the Doorlord. Not sure about that. Ah, dang it. Oh well. Still doesn't really matter all that much. Just essentially lost one half heart. Ow. And another one. I can have some of these. Until I run out. Ooh. Did you teleport? I didn't know you could teleport. Alright, that only affects regular bullets and not laser things. That was really close. Oh yeah, I probably have seen him do that before. Alright. Irradiated lead. Get some health back. Still doing rather well this time, of course. And then we're going down to the next floor. For the first time during Boss Rush. And this is going to be a bit of a longer episode than usual. Than my usual target, because we are currently at 34 minutes already. Poison the wall. Okay, so I figured out how to deal with that fire without taking damage from it. I have to run into the fire and actually... because the flaw in my previous strategy have been that I've been trying to dodge across the fire without actually walking in it. To avoid actually getting set on fire. But that doesn't really work. Because it's too wide. But if I walk into the fire and let myself get set on fire, and then dodge roll out of it optimally, the roll will then put the fire out. Oh dear. I'm going to be able to take this out. Let's activate that. There we go. Hopefully I'm not on fire right now. Okay, goes out, and we get the serious cannon. I think for the first time, well, actually no, this is not an actual run, is it? Do we have health? No. We just came down to this floor. I wonder if these have something in them. Probably not. No, can't even go down there. Just get teleported back up. Alright. I'm going to switch to this. Because why wouldn't I? Whoop. Ah. No flawless on this one. I hate this boss in general. It's one of the more bullet hell-y ones, I suppose. Maybe we don't like them. Here again. God damn it. I really hate the bosses that go into modes where you or stages where you can't hit them. It's pretty annoying. Where are you? There. I mean, it's bad enough when they are hard to hit. But impossible to hit? Do they have to? Get hit there despite the deflector thing. Okay. There we go. Still made it. Hopefully I get a bunch of health back. Well, one heart. Still, we are above 50%, which is good. Just going to continue without too much delay. Hopefully this, if I beat this, it will count as a well, as a victory for the hunting quest. Okay. I did not mean to use a blank there, but whatever. Did not mean to use a piece of armor there. Quite amazed that I didn't get hit there. Or there. Well, I did get hit. But you know. No, go away. Shouldn't you just put out three beams when one of you are dead? Really do with another one of you dying now, yes. There was one of the instances of me not being able to look when the effect expired. Polaris unlocked, and I got the Hollowed Out achievement. We get the gun boots, which aren't going to be particularly useful right now. Polaris has joined the shootout. Okay. And then, unfortunately, I didn't get a master round on this floor. So, yeah. I guess the boss rush would be one of the better options. Well, maybe not. I mean, for one, maybe it doesn't count. And the only boss on this floor is the dragon, isn't it? Yeah. Haven't fought this guy in a little while now. And this is going to be a pretty long episode. Let's skip the introduction. His head is hit. His head moves, which is a bit annoying. Oh, I don't really remember his attacks. All right. Okay. Right now it's empty, and I'm actually running out of ammo. Yeesh. I do not remember that attack at all. And I wasn't really looking where I was. Alright, so that is going to mark the end of this episode, of course. We are going to quickly go check with these guys over here, see if the count has gone down to 2. Yes, it has. Alright. That is good. So I'm going to continue playing Boss Rush, probably kill the Kill Pillars a couple more times, and then we can turn in that quest, maybe in the next episode, and see what we get and what the next one is. And I will see you then.